Hello viewers, I am Noel Shed from CircuitIGS. Today I am demonstrating the Blink LED on Raspberry Pi Pico using C++ SDK. Now you can see the Raspberry Pi Pico is mounted on a breadboard and is also connected to the USB with the one end. Another end is loosely connected to the system's USB because I am using one hand to operate the whole thing. Now you can see system screen. I am using Ubuntu 20.04 and in a screen already the Visual Studio is open and the main.c where the LED blink code is written. Okay, now we can click on the at the bottom we can click on the CMake debug ready. When I click at the upper portion, we select the debug. Now we can see the output terminal, the CMake build is run, and as well as the build folder also created in the project folder. After run the CMake build, now we can click on the build to build the full code. After clicking on the build code, the build process is start. Now you can see the build process is on process, and after the 100% the build target is ready. Now we can go back to the build folder. We can see the loss of file is created and blinkled.ef2 also created, which is the executable file for Raspberry Pi Pico. Now it's time to mount the Raspberry Pi as a storage device, removable storage device, to load this UF2 file into the Raspberry Pi Pico to blinking the LED. Now we already see the Raspberry Pi Pico has a boot select button. So we have to press the boot select button and plug the USB. Now I'm pressing the boot select button on the thumb and put the USB in it. Now a sound came up in the screen. Wait for a few seconds. Now Raspberry Pi P2, RPI P2 is already mounted. Now you can see here like this. Okay. Now you open this folder, removal folder, this one. Here has two folder, index.html, uf2.txt. This is two folder already been preloaded in the Raspberry Pi file system. Now it's time to copy the code into this drive. So open the file system. In a new window, make it smaller. Now in my case I am using Raspberry Pi Pico, then the Pico workspace, LED blink, build, and here I have the EF2 file. Now I have to copy this EF2 file into the Raspberry Pi file system. Drag and drop the UF2 file and it will automatically disconnect the Raspberry Pi mass storage and the blink will be started. Now you can see the LED is blinking about 250 milliseconds gapping. Thank you guys.